Carmen's gang is bankrolled by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and viewers like you.
This program is brought to you by the Hotel for Family Fun, all over the world, Holiday Inn, and...
This program is brought to you by Toyota.
All these people want to know, where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And one of these people could find her. Got Drew Jones. Jennifer Wynn. Bryan Niederman. Today's episode, The Case of the Missing Mountain. And this man is special agent in charge of training new recruits.
Hey guys, how are you?
Greg Lee!
Hi.
Thank you. Hi guys, how are you?
Fine.
Hey. Ready to get started?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get the chief up here on the monitor. Chief, you there?
I'm here, Greg.
Let's get started.
All right, Gumshoes. Carmen Sandiego and her horde of heinous henchmen has struck again. This time they've nabbed the Matterhorn. Situated in the Pennine Alps, bordering Switzerland and Italy, the majestic mountain has been a favorite attraction for hikers and skiers for centuries. Now this morning, as the sun's first rays glinted off the glacial peak, the Contessa crept the Matterhorn and ripped it right out of the Alps. She reportedly wants to open her own ski resort. Here's the lowdown on the Contessa. She's upper crust, upper class, and up to no good. Your mission, Gumshoes. Dismount the selfish Contessa, remount the Matterhorn, and then capture Carmen Sandiego. Greg.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, Gumshoes, we're going to start you off with 50 Acme crime bucks. Anytime you answer a question correctly, we'll give you 10 more crime bucks. And the two of you with the highest scores at the end of this round will then proceed to the next round, okay? Mm-hmm. Chief, let's go, Chief.
All right. Now, according to our latest information, the Contessa parked the peak in a Mediterranean port. It also happens to be the capital of a North African nation. It was originally one of three cities settled by the Phoenicians. And in fact, its name comes from the Greek for with three cities. Greg.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, name the city. Is it Tunis, Tripoli, or Tangier? Remember the clues that we heard? Mediterranean port, capital of North African nation, and name comes from the Greek for with three cities. Jennifer's ready, so is Scott. Bryan waiting on you. Here we go. Scott, what do you say?
I said Tunis.
Tunis. What do you think, Jennifer?
Tripoli.
Tripoli. What do you think, Bryan?
Tripoli.
Tripoli. The answer we're looking for is Tripoli. Nice job, Jennifer and Bryan. There goes the contestant. Okay, so that means, Jennifer, you have 60, Scott, you have 50, Bryan, you have 60. Nice job, everybody. Before we get too far into this, though, let's find out a little bit more about you detectives, shall we? Scott, I understand that you collect comics, right?
Yeah.
What kind do you do? What's your favorite?
Spider-Man.
Spider-Man?
Yeah.
That's my favorite, too.
Yeah?
Yeah, I love him. Yeah, I used to read him a long time, then I quit reading him, and when I came back, he was married, and some redheaded girl, right?
Yeah, Mary Jane.
What's her name?
Mary Jane.
Mary Jane, yes, Mary Jane.
Did you know he changed his... costume to black because the alien took over his body?
I didn't know any of this stuff. So he's in a black uniform now?
No, he changed back to his original.
Oh, now he's back. Okay. Excuse us for just a moment, and now we'll go on. Okay, nice to have you on the case, Scott. Jennifer, you collect postcards.
Yes, I do.
Tell me about that. How'd you get started with that?
Well, my father would travel a lot, and he'd buy me postcards to show me where he's been.
Oh, that's great. Great way to learn about the world. Nice to have you on the case. And, Bryan, you collect something, too. What do you collect?
I collect shells.
Great. How'd you get into that?
Well, when I go down the shore, I find shells on the beach and in the water, so I take the interesting ones.
Cool. What's your favorite?
Purple clam.
Purple clam. All right. Good to have you guys on the show. Let's give them a round of applause, you guys. Here they are. Good to have you here. Get started now. I understand now that Acme NewsNet agent Arthur Kent has some information on where the Contessa is headed. Arthur?
The Contessa loves the Adriatic Sea. She's staying at a palazzo on the Grand Canal, not far from St. Mark's Square. It's so quiet there, you can almost hear the bridges sigh.
Okay, thanks, Arthur. Name the city, everybody. Is it Valencia, Venice, or Palermo? Remember the clues that we heard? Adriatic Sea, Palazzo on the Grand Canal, and St. Mark's Square. Come up with an answer as quickly as you can. Jennifer's ready. So is Scott and Bryan. We're waiting on you. Come on, Pally. Do it. Do it, Matt. All right. Scott, what do you say?
I said Palermo.
Palermo. What do you think, Jennifer?
Venice.
Venice. What do you think, Bryan?
Venice.
Venice. The answer we're looking for is Venice. Nice job, Jennifer, Bryan. Okay, so that means, Scott, you have 50. Jennifer, you have 70. And, Bryan, you have 70. That's the way to do it, guys. Stay
Greg.
Right in it. Yeah, Chief?
Greg.
Yeah.
Just got a call from Lemke. Says we're in violation of the EPC again.
Oh, no. Educational puppet code?
No
problem. We'll handle it out here. You see, folks, we want to give equal time to puppets here on this show. So please welcome, if you will, Andy the Puppet.
Thank you very much. It's good to be here. Gregory, as you know, it's customary to build an observatory on a mountain. Well, the Contessa did it the other way around. She took her mountain to an observatory. It's called Chum Sung Dae. It was built in the 7th century out of over 360 stones. It's on a peninsula in Asia that produces animation for a lot of cartoons we see on TV. What do you think of that?
I think
that's
it's
very amazing.
Nice, huh?
He's a cutie.
Andy the Puppet. Andy the Puppet, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Get out of here. Okay, Gumshoe's, name the country, if you will, please. Is it South Korea, Vietnam, or Cambodia? Remember the clues that we heard from Handy? Chum Sung Dae Observatory, peninsula in Asia, and animation for cartoons that we see. Scott is ready. Jennifer is ready. Bryan, waiting on you. Come on, pal. What do you say? He's ready. Scott, what do you say?
South Korea.
South Korea. Jennifer?
South Korea.
South Korea. Bryan?
South Korea.
South Korea. The answer we're looking for is South Korea. Nice job, guys. So, Scott, that takes you up to 60. Jennifer and Bryan, you both have 80. That's the way to do it, guys. Stay right with it. Hot on the trail. Okay, wait a minute. That only means one thing. It's time for the lightning round. So what we're going to do is I have three questions here. Any one of you that answers any one of these questions correctly, I'll give you an extra five crime bucks. So hands on the buzzers. Listen closely. Here we go. Traditionally, Korean meals include soup, fish, vegetables, and a spicy dish called kimchi. Is kimchi marinated beef, marinated short ribs, or pickled cabbage? Scott.
Pickled cabbage?
Pickled cabbage is right. Nice job. Give you five more. All right, question two. The pock posts in the Gwangwon-do province are natural wonders. They become raging marvels when the monsoons blow in off the Indian Ocean. Are pock posts waterfalls, geysers, or lava flows? Bryan.
Lava flows.
Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Scott.
Water flows.
Water flows. Can we accept that? Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Jennifer.
Waterfalls.
Waterfalls is the answer we're looking for. Nice job. Sorry, Scott, you understand. We're looking for waterfalls, not water flows. Okay. Question three. Take out your wallets. If you're trading in your dollars for South Korean currency, will you receive won, yuan, or yen? Scott.
Won.
Won is right. Nice job, Scott. Put you back in the game. You're up to 70. Jennifer, you have 85. Bryan, you have 80. Very close game, you guys. Now, I want to remind you, we're still looking for the Contessa and the mountain. The one of you that catches any one of those will then have a chance to try to catch Carmen Sandiego.
Greg.
Yeah, Chief.
Greg, I have an incentive for the Gumshoes.
Great.
Gumshoes. If one of you captures Carmen Sandiego, I will send you anywhere in the lower 48 states. That's good. You can try a vacation in, Santa Claus, Indiana, or Knoxville, Virginia, or Zig Zag, Oregon, or Dink, West Virginia, anywhere. But before you're going to get this reward, you have to capture the Contessa first. So get to it, Greg.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, remember, got to catch the Contessa, got to get back that mountain. All right, now, Acme Bugnet has now given us a recording of a phone conversation between the Contessa and Carmen Sandiego. Listen.
Contessa, they've spotted your mountain. You'd better hide in the richest island in the Pacific. It's located north of New Zealand and just south of the equator.
Ooh, that's my kind of place.
It's rich because it's covered with guano.
What is this guano? A cologne?
Fertilizer made of bird droppings. This island sells it and makes a lot of money.
Aye, Carmen, you are so cruel to me.
Oh, hush. I hate to hear a grown crook cry.
Okay, Gumshoes, name the island. Is it Nauru, Fiji, Papua New Guinea? Remember the clues that we heard? Sells fertilizer called guano north of New Zealand, just south of the equator. Okay, Scott, what do you think?
I say Fiji.
Fiji. What do you think, Jennifer?
Fiji.
Fiji. Brian?
Papua New
Guinea. Papua New Guinea. The answer we're looking for is Nauru. Sorry, guys. Tough break there. Nobody gets anything. Okay, so that means, Scott, you have 70. Jennifer, you have 85. Brian, you have 80. Now, the Contessa sailed north.
Will you stop the noise down there?
That's my upstairs neighbor, Mrs. Pumpkin Clanger. Come on. Hi.
Get on with it, man. She went to Central America, to a country that's world famous for its beautiful mahogany. She's staying in the capital city. It's up in the highlands where the climate is perfect. Warm days and cool nights all year round. Now nab her and quiet down.
Oh, hey. I guess you put me in my place. All right, guys, name the Central American country. Is it Guatemala, Honduras, or Belize? Remember the clues that we heard? Mahogany, capital city, and highlands. Everybody's ready. Scott, what do you say?
I said Honduras.
Honduras. Jennifer?
Honduras.
Honduras. Brian?
Guatemala.
Guatemala. The answer we're looking for is Honduras. Nice job, Scott and Jennifer. Okay, so that means, Scott, you have 80. Jennifer, you have 95. Brian, you have 80. Now, one of our Acme Yankee Net agents just saw the Contessa at an away game. Come in, Pat Kelly.
When you fly into that city for a game, sometimes you can see Mount Rainier from above. There are amazing floating bridges that go over Lake Washington to Mercer Island, but we don't go over them between the airport and the kingdom.
Thanks, Pat. Okay, guys, name the city. Is it Portland, Seattle, or San Francisco? Remember the clues that we heard? Lake Washington to Mercer Island bridges, Mount Rainier, and Kingdom. Okay, Scott, what do you say?
I said Seattle.
Seattle. What do you think, Jennifer?
Seattle.
Seattle. Brian?
Seattle.
Seattle. The answer is Seattle. Please. Nice job. Oh, there she goes again. Stay hot on it, you guys. Okay, now it's time for the final clue of this round, which means you got to make a decision. How much do you want to risk? If you're right, we'll add that amount to your score. If you're not right, we'll subtract it from your score. You can risk 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, or 50 Acme Crime Bucks. Take a look right over here at Gumshoes. Here's a portion of the world where we think the Contessa is headed. Now, if you know a lot about this part of the world, you may want to risk a lot. If you don't know very much about it, though, you may not want to risk quite so much. So take a look at it and think about it.
Think about it, how much you're gonna risk. Think about it.
Okay, it looks like everybody's made a decision. Nice job, guys. For our last clue, hey, wait a minute. Looks like my old friend over there. For our last clue, we're gonna go to a good buddy of mine. Everybody stay calm. Listen very closely. Good pally of mine. And his name is The Fly!
The Contessa is in one of my favorite places. I love that salsa, the music, and the food. But I have to watch out for the coqui. That's Spanish for little frogs. Well, they make lunch out of me. I spotted her sunning herself on Luquillo Beach. The coconut oil on her tanning lotion drove me crazy.
Good buddy, The Fly, ladies and gentlemen. A flying, talking fly. Okay, guys, name the island. Is it Cuba, Puerto Rico, or Jamaica? Remember the clues that we heard? Salsa, music, and food. Coqui, Luquillo Beach. Okay, we're going to start with you, Scott. You have 90 crime bucks. Before you show me your answer, how much did you risk?
I risked 50 crime
50.
Bucks.
Going to put you in the lead if you're right. What'd you say?
I said Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico's right. Good job, Scotty. Nice job. Takes you up to 140. You're in the lead. Brian, you also were at 90. How much did you risk?
30 crime bucks.
30 or 20? You have 20 up there. How much did you want to risk?
20.
20? Okay. 20, then we'll put you over 100. Put you in second place if you're right. What'd you say?
Cuba.
Oh, tough break. Going to go down 20, but wait, it's not over yet, though. We'll find out what's happening. It takes you down to 70. Jennifer, you're in the second place right now with 105. How much did you risk?
I risked 20 crime bucks.
You risked 20. What did you say?
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico is right. Nice job. I mean, Scott and Jennifer, you're going on to the next round. Brian, listen, pal, you were a great detective, man. You did some great stuff for us today. We've assembled a kit that's going to help you in your next case. Chief?
It's the official Acme Crime Net travel kit, and it includes a World Traveler's Atlas, an official Carmen watch, a Carmen sweatshirt, and a subscription to National Geographic World magazine. And our thanks for your good work on this case. Brian, I salute you.
Thanks, Chief. Okay, guys, now it's time for you to go to Puerto Rico to try to track down the Contessa and get that Matterhorn back. What you have to do is find them and bring them back. I want you to know, though, we did not send our agents out into the field unprepared. Chief, how about a briefing?
Here's the scoop on Puerto Rico. U.S. possession located in the Northern Caribbean. Puerto Ricans are American citizens, but they don't pay federal taxes or vote in presidential elections. Spanish is the official language, and English is taught in the schools. Now, the boys down at Photo Recon have put together a few slides for us. Now, as you sail into San Juan Bay, you'll see El Moro, a Spanish fort on San Juan Bay, completed 1589. Casablanca, old San Juan, oldest house in Puerto Rico. It was built for explorer Ponce de Leon in 1521. Now, the Contessa loves classy real estate, so look for her here. Check for the Matterhorn in El Yunque Tropical Forest. It gets more rain than any other part of Puerto Rico, 100 billion gallons a year. Now, if the Contessa really wants to hide out, she'll head for the Camuy Caves. Now, don't be afraid to go inside. Lots of people do, but wear a hat. Now, the ceilings are full of bats, and, well, they eat a lot, and, well, you know. All right, Gumshoes, if things start to get ugly, call on the local Acme Crime Net Bureau chief. His name's Ted Brannon, and he's a darn good man. And there's one thing, though, his taste in clothes is a bit out of the ordinary. It's not bad, you see. It's just a bit odd. Well, a uniform's a uniform, right? Just don't wrinkle his cape, and you'll be fine. All right, Gumshoes. The Contessa and the Matterhorn are in Puerto Rico. Hit the road!
All right, Gumshoes, come on in here. Here we are, Puerto Rico. Set your stuff down right here. Take a walk right over there, if you will. Please let me show you what we have. Here are the locations where you might be able to find the Contessa and the Matterhorn and a warrant for the Contessa's arrest. Now, the first thing you have to do is find the loot. That's the evidence you need so that you can get a warrant. With the warrant, you can then arrest the crook. Now, you have to connect all three of those things in that order, the loot, the warrant, the crook, in a single turn. If you do that, then you get a chance to try to catch Carmen Sandiego. Catch Carmen Sandiego, and you get that trip to anywhere in the lower 48 United States. Now, one more thing. You can pick any one of these locations that you want to. If you happen upon, though, the loot, the warrant, or the crook, you get a free turn, okay? Scott, you were ahead at the end of the last round. You go first.
Cafe de Los Amigos.
Los Amigos Cafe. Nothing there. Jennifer.
The Tapia Theater.
The Tapia Theater. Nothing there. Scott.
Mosquito Pier.
Mosquito Pier. Nope, not there. Jennifer.
San Juan Cemetery.
San Juan Cemetery. Not there. Scott.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove.
The warrant.
Okay, that's the warrant. Nice job. But remember, you have to get it in the right order. Loot, warrant, crook. Go ahead.
El Moro.
El Moro. Nothing there. Nice job, Scott. You got one of them. Go ahead, Jennifer.
Blue Beach.
The Blue Beach. Nope, sorry. Scott.
Old Walled City.
Old Walled City. Okay, nice job. You got the loot. Go ahead, you get a free turn.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove.
The warrant.
There's the loot, there's the warrant. You need one more to find the Contessa.
Arecibo Observatory.
Nope, not there. You got two of them, though. Go ahead, Jennifer.
Okay, Old Walled City.
Old Walled City.
Yodelay-ee-hoo.
Free turn. Go ahead, Jennifer.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove.
The warrant.
There's two.
Casablanca.
Casablanca. Not there. Almost. Go ahead, Scotty.
Old Walled City.
Old Walled City.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove. Second choice. Pine Grove. Go ahead.
And Puerto Diablo.
The warrant.
And what's the third one?
Puerto Diablo.
Puerto Diablo. Not there. Okay. Go ahead, Jennifer.
Old Walled City.
Old Walled City. Go ahead.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove.
The warrant.
Go ahead.
Ocean Park.
Ocean Park. Is it there? Oh. Tough break. Go ahead, Scott.
Old Walled City.
Old Walled City.
Pine Grove.
Now choose.
Pine Grove.
Pine Grove.
The warrant.
And Camuy Caves.
Camuy Caves. Oh! Oh, yeah! Come here, Scotty. Nice job, my man. Have a stand right over here. Okay, look. You got the Contessa. The last thing you have to do now is put her in jail. Pull on that chain and do it.
Contessa.
Okay, Scott, we're going to talk about your next adventure in just a little bit. But first, Jennifer, listen, you are a great detective. You tracked the Contessa all the way to Puerto Rico. We got some great stuff for you. Chief.
It's a pocket translator for instant translations of 14,000 words and phrases in 10 European languages. Nice work, Jennifer.
Okay, Scott, I have something. You have to keep this top secret, though. Some paperwork, okay? Inside, there's a piece of paper. There's also a pen. What I want you to do is write down where you'd like to go if you capture Carmen Sandiego and get that trip. Do it. Job. Nice job. Look, you're having a good day, right? You got the Contessa, you got the Matterhorn back. Everybody's happy about that. The only thing you have to do left now is... Hold on a second. Can you get that? Let me get that. Da-da-da. Yes? Yeah, he's right here. Hold on.
Huh? Honor among thieves? Surely you jest. If I'm going to prison, I'm taking Carmen with me. Look for her in Africa.
Okay, Scott. Looks like you and I are going to Africa. Chief?
Scott. Here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled. Mauritania, Senegal, Algeria, Mali, Niger, Gabon, Namibia, Egypt, Uganda, Zimbabwe, Swaziland, Ethiopia, Madagascar. Greg, take Scott to the map!
Come on, let's hear it. All right, bud. This is what it's all about right here, right? What you have to do now is track Carmen Sandiego through 7 different countries, identifying each country with a marker. If you're right, you'll hear this sound. But if you're wrong, you'll hear this sound. Now, if you're wrong 2 times, leave the marker where it is. Don't worry about it. If you're right, though, 7 times in 45 seconds, you will then win that trip to wherever you wrote in that portfolio. What do you think?
Yes.
What do you guys think of that? Yeah! All right, come up here, cheer them on. Let's get this thing going. Let's get 45 seconds up on the clock. Good luck to you, Scott. On your mark, get set, go. Carmen went to Mali. Mali. Nope, try it again. Try it again, come on. Madagascar. Yeah, you got it. Come on, you got it. Senegal, Carmen went to Senegal. Nope, try it again. Senegal. Come on, go on to the next. Zimbabwe. Carmen went to Zimbabwe. No. Try it again. Hurry. Okay, here we go. Carmen went to Egypt. You got it. Carmen went to Namibia. Try it again. Hurry. No. Oh, tough break. He got 2 in 45 seconds. Not bad. Give him a round of applause, guys. Here, bub. Listen, you know, sometimes it's just tough. Carmen Sandiego is just tough to catch sometimes. You did the best you could. You didn't do bad. And besides, you did get the Contessa earlier. That's not bad. Chief, what do you think of that?
Well, we're all proud of the good work you did here throughout the day, Scott. And we here at headquarters, well, we pitched in and we purchased a portable CD player we thought you would enjoy and a selection of CDs from around the world.
That's not bad, right, CD?
No.
Okay. All right, now look. You've been working really hard for us today. There's one more thing I want you to do. You know what it is.
Do it,
Rockefeller!